Our next topic is curves. Okay, curve means, you know, the curve is an arc, or curve might be anything. Okay, straight line is also a curve which is having infinity radius. Okay, circle is also a curve which is having finite radius. Like curves are there. In curves, there are several types. One is by sectioning a cone. By sectioning a cone, you will get conic sections. You will get conic sections and conics. So what is the difference between conic sections and conics? I will let you know. Okay. And next, according to the locus of a point rolling on element, according to the locus of a point which is rolling on element, then you will get roulettes. Roulettes means nothing but cycloid, involute, trapezoid, these things. Okay, next differentiation is locus of a moving point. Locus of a moving point will gives you spirals. Locus of a moving point will gives you spirals. In the spiral, you will have Archimedean spiral, Archimedean spiral, helix, like that. Okay, clear? So next, so what is the difference between conic section and conics? Before going to that, first of all, let me tell you one thing. What is a cone? What is a cone? Cone will be shaped like this. This is the shape of cone. Okay. And in this cone also, we have regular and irregular. If it is a regular cone, then it will be right circular cone. This is called it as right circular cone. If it is irregular, then it is called it as oblique cone. Then it is called as oblique cone. Okay. So now, as we are going to deal with only regular things, so now we need to consider regular cone. What is a regular cone? It is right circular cone. Now I will tell you what is right circular cone. Right circular cone means this is a right angle triangle. This is a right angle triangle. Now what I will do is, I am fixing one of the side of this right angle triangle as axis. I am fixing this one. Okay. This is O and this is B. Okay. And this is O dash. Okay. By fixing O and O dash, what I am doing is I am rotating OB. So locus of this OB, that means by fixing O and O dash, if you rotate OB for one revolution, what will happen? It will form a circular shape. It will not form a circular shape. It will form a, it's form a circular shape. Okay. So for half revolution, B will be like this. For another half, it will go like this. Okay. So join this. Now what you got? This is known as right circular cone. Right circular cone is formed by the locus of a line. Where is that line? That line is nothing but a side of the right angle triangle. Okay. So now I will tell you nomenclature of this cone. How this cone looks like. See, this is the axis point. So this is the axis line. This is the cone. In this cone, this is called it as axis. And this is known as base. This is called as base. Okay. And what are these two, sir? These two are known as end generators. These two are known as end generators. Okay. So this is the point O. This is called it as apex. This is called it as apex. What is apex? Where two end generators meet. Not only two end generators. A cone will have so many generators. Why? Because of this is the line which is the locus. And this locus will be like this also. At several positions on the base, this locus of the line will take so many positions in this path. So there will be so many generators. Infinity number of generators. Number of generators in a cone is infinity. But only end generators are identical. Only end generators are identical. Okay. So all the where all the generators meet the axis point is known as apex. Apex means the point where all the generators meet axis point. Meet the axis point is nothing but the apex point. Okay. Now the angle made by one of the generators and the axis is known as alpha. Is known as alpha. This alpha is known as semicone angle. This alpha is known as semicone angle. Okay. If the angle between two end generators will be 2 alpha, this 2 alpha known as cone angle. This 2 alpha is known as cone angle. Okay. We have very huge applications with this alpha and 2 alpha. Okay. So now you got to know about what is apex point. In cone, the total nomenclature you got to know. This is the main important thing. Number of generators in a cone will be infinity. But number of identical generators are only end generators. Those are 2. That you need to make a note. Okay. And the angle made by axis and one of the end generator will be semicone angle. And the angle between two end generators will be cone angle, 2 alpha. Cone angle alpha is semicone angle. Okay. So now this is about conic sections. Conic sections are formed by sectioning a cone. Now you got to know about cone. Then I will tell you how conic sections will form and how conics are formed. And in depth subject about these two. Okay. Tell you what is the cone, what is a conic, and what is this conic section. Conic section is a materialized one. Conic section is a materialized one. Materialized one means it's like a solid. Conic is hollow cone. Conic is nothing but hollow cone. Okay. Now I will tell you, if you want to divide this cone, I have to divide it like this. If you want to do any sectioning, you have to divide it like this. But for conic section, one cone will be there. That's enough. That's enough. See, this is the cone. Okay, this is O. This is the axis. Okay, so this is the base, these are the end generators. Okay, now curves formed by sectioning the conic sections are conic section, conics. Okay, so now I will tell you what type of points and what type of curves we will get by sectioning this cone. Okay, by sectioning this cone in different orientations, what type of curves we will get, I will let you know. Okay, now suppose, see, this is the axis. Now, what I am doing is to divide this one, I am taking the use of a cutting plane or a sectioning plane. How a cutting plane or sectioning plane will be there? Ends are thick. Ends are thick. In last class only I told you, okay, ends are thick. So now I am dividing this cone like this. See, it is semicone angle. It is cone angle. Okay, so now what happened? This axis is perpendicular to this sectioning plane. Let us say this is as 1-1. Let us say this is as 1-1. Then which type of curve I will get? I will get the curve with the condition of 1-1 is circle. Is circle. Okay. Here the theta is equal to 90 degrees. Theta is equal to 90 degrees. Next, what I am going to do is, I am going to divide this one like this. I will use different pen. This is section 2-2. What happened here? What's the thing happened here? Here the section plane is cutting two generators. Is the cutting plane is cutting two generators, and the angle here, and the angle here, the theta is less than that of alpha. Less than that of alpha. So here, what type of, if the section plane cuts both the generators with 90, less than that of 90 degrees, and what type of section plane you will get, what type of curve you will get? You will get ellipse. With the 2-2, you will get ellipse. Okay. Next, if the section planes cuts the cone, see, here I am drawing, this is the cone. And here what I am doing, this is the axis. Here what happened is, the section plane cuts the cone, which is parallel to, with the parallel to end generator, with the parallel to one of the end generator. Here what happened? 3-3. If this section plane is parallel to end generator, means the angle made by this with the axis and the angle made by this end generator with the axis will become semicone angle. Will become semicone angle. Why? Because of this is parallel to this is one. Okay. So this is parallel to this one. So the angle made by this will be angle made by this. So this will be theta is equal to alpha. And the curve what we are going to get is parabola. You will get parabola. And there is another case. This is the cone. This is the axis. Okay. Now what I am doing is, I am dividing this one less than that of alpha. That means it is like this. Okay. Theta is less than that of, sorry, it is not less than, it is greater than. Okay. Theta is less than that of alpha, and it is not passing through the axis. See, here it passes through the axis. While it is parallel, even if it is parallel, the section plane cuts the axis also. Here the section plane is unable to cut the axis. Then what type of curve you will get? You will get it is hyperbola. You will get hyperbola. Okay. Next, what I am doing is, I am cutting this cone with a section plane which is parallel to the axis. Which is parallel to the axis. Okay. So what you will get here? Theta is equal to 0, then you will get rectangular hyperbola. Then you will get rectangular hyperbola. Okay, so this is 5-5. Okay, here see, even axis and this section plane both are parallel to each other. In case if they coincide with each other, 6-6. If they coincide with each other, then I will get isosceles triangle. Then I will get isosceles triangle. Okay. So, this is isosceles triangle, rectangular triangle. Now you got all the conic sections. Now you got all the conic sections. In cone also it is same. This is the cone. Two cones will be there. Base. Okay. Okay, when it comes to halo cone, what will be there? Halo cone means, halo cone is nothing but the conic. Okay, see here, if you cut like this, you will get circle. Same as in conic section. Okay, here, if you cut it with like this, then you will get ellipse. If you cut this, if you cut this one with the parallelism of this end generator, then you will get parabola. If you cut it like this, then you will get hyperbola. If you cut it like this, then you will get rectangular hyperbola. Okay, so if you, this is the axis. Okay, if you, if this section plane passes through this one, then what you will get here, you will get isosceles triangle, but here you will get straight line. Here you will get straight line. This is the difference between conic and conic section. Why? Because of it is a halo cone, that's why you will get a straight line. Here you will get, there you will get an isosceles triangle. Okay, so conic means there will be two parts, two cones will be together, okay, and one of this part will be known as nappy. One of this cone is known as nappy. Okay, so this is about cone and conic sections. Okay, clear? So from conic sections, what are the curves you will get? You will get circle, ellipse, parabola, hyperbola, rectangular hyperbola. In case of conic section, you will get isosceles triangle. In case of conic, you will get straight line. Okay, so how these things will be differentiated with the help of directrix, now I will tell you. Okay, see, for circle, how circle looks like? It looks like this. Okay, this is the circle, this is the origin O. That is, that means the center point. Okay, here the fixer points and origin coincides each other. The fixer points and the origin coincides with each other, and fixer straight lines are infinity distance. All right, infinity distance, infinity, it will be there with infinity. The distance here is infinity, and this is the v1 v2. This is the V1 and V2. Okay, so this is for circle. Here for the circle, E is equal to 0. Here for the circle, E is equal, what is E? That is eccentricity. I will let you know what it is. First of all, how these things are looks like. I will let you know. Circle looks like this. And then ellipse. How an ellipse looks like? This directrix will come near. Okay. Two directrices are at infinity distance. Now these directrix will come closer like this. These fixed lines are called as directrix. This line is called it as axis. Okay, so now on axis, directrix comes close. When directrix comes close, these f1 and f2 will go apart. O will be there itself only, and f1 and f2 will move long, f1. As f1 and f2 also move, so v1 and v2 also will move. This is ellipse. Okay, so see this, this is the axis, this is the directrix. What happened here? The directrix is at infinity distance, and here the directrix are all closer to each other. Then what happened? This focus move like this, and vortices also stretched like this. So when directrix comes closer, the curvature got extended. So that's why this is V1, V2, this is F1, F2. Next, for parabola. For parabola, what will happen? These directrices will come more close. this directrix will come more close. Okay, this is the origin O. Okay, then what will happen? This F1 and V1 will move like this. This is V2 and this is F2. Then what will happen? It will stretch more. After keep on stretching like this, what will happen? It will break. This is the ellipse now. Ellipse got? If you are keep on stretching this one, then what will have to happen? It breaks like this. Okay? It breaks and it will become as a open curvature. Two parabolas are there. These are open curvatures. That's why these are called it as bola. Bola means open bowl, like bowl or not. Okay? So this is parabola as open curvature. Okay? Now what will happen? Next, for hyperbola. Next for hyperbola, these directrices will come more closer. The directrices will come more closer. So directrices will come more closer. What will happen here? This F1 will cross the V1. See, this is the V1. This is the F1. This is the V2. This is the F2. This is how the hyperbola will be. Now what will happen? By the directrices come more closer, then this parabola became like this. This parabola will become like this. So in this manner, the hyperbola came. This is hyperbola. This is also open curve. That's why bola. Okay. Hyper means more. See, this is somehow close. This is somehow close. After some time, it will parabola will become parallel. But they won't. At infinity, they will meet. So we cannot see. So that's why that came parabola. This is hyperbola. Why? Because of it is like this. Hyperbola is like this. If it is like this, these endpoints are not parallel with each other. So that's why this is hyperbola, and you will get asymptotes like this. You will get asymptotes like this. Okay. Then if directrices came more close and coincide with each other, then you will get straight line. Then you will get straight line. Okay, so this is the common feature. Now I will tell you what is eccentricity, what is conic nature. So the next concept is, what is a conic? Conic means the ratio of distance of a point to the fixed point and the distance of a point with a fixed line should be always constant. Should be always constant. Okay, so like you see, this is the circle. So this is the directrix. Directrices are infinity at distance. This is O. F1 and F2 are same. V2 and V1 are apart. Okay. So this here, what he is saying, the ratio of distances to the point, to the fixed point. See, this is the fixed point and this is the point. The distance between here to here and the distance of a point with a fixed line and the distance of a point with a fixed line. This is the fixed line. These distances, the ratio of these two distances, this, let's say this distance as A, this distance as B, then A by B should be constant. The ratio of A by B should be constant. That's what he is saying. That means not only in a straight way, but also like this. Even if you consider a point here like this, the distance between here to here will be A1. The distance between here to here will be B1. This A1 by B1 also should be constant. At any extent, it should be, if it is constant, then it is known as conics. Okay, so circle also is a type of conic. Okay, next, what I am doing is, for this moving point, I am giving a name vertex. For this fixed point, I am giving a name focus. And for this fixed straight line, I am giving a name directrix. And this one I am giving a name as axis. Okay. Now, what is eccentricity? The eccentricity means the ratio of distances between vertex to focus. The ratio of distance between vertex to focus and the distance between vertex to directrix should be constant. Should be constant. E is equal to, E should be constant every time. it is denoted by, eccentricity is denoted by E. For circle, E is equal to 0. For circle, E is equal to 0. Next thing is for ellipse. For ellipse, how it will be? Let's see. For ellipse, directrices came close. Directrices came close. So this is the V1, this is the V2, this is the F1, and this is the F2. This is the F1 and this is the F2. Okay. So now this is the O. Now for ellipse eccentricity, what will be there? For any conic section, the eccentricity formula and the eccentricity definition is same. Here what he is saying, let's consider this is as F1. Okay. If you consider any point here, the distance between this moving point is called as vertices. This is V1, let's say this is a small V1. Distance between F1 to V1, the ratio of distance between F1 to small V1 and directrix D1, small V1 to small D1 should be constant. Should be constant. But for ellipse, what will be there is, this is A, no? What I said, this is A and this is B. For ellipse, A by B, this A will be smaller one. This A, the distance of fixed point, the distance of fixed point to vertex, I mean fixed point to moving point is lesser. Okay? And the distance between vertex to directrix is more. This distance is more. Here what it is? A is less than that of B. Okay. So this is lesser one, this is bigger one. So what will happen? This will become in 0 point something. In 0 point something will be there, the ratio. So that's why for ellipse, eccentricity E is equal to 0 point something. So what I'm doing is, I'm saying E is less than 1. E is less than 1. This is how ellipse is formed. Then to define an ellipse, you can say like this, where the distance of vertices, I mean the ratio of distance of vertex to fixed vertex to focus and the distance between vertex to directrix is less than that of 1 for ellipse. Where E is less than that of 1. What is E? Now you got to know. Okay. This is about ellipse. Then what is for parabola? For parabola, parabola will be like this. This is the V1 and this is the F1. This is the parabola. Okay. For parabola, this is A and this is B. For parabola also, E formula will be same. E is equal to A by B. That means the distance of focus to vertex and the vertex to directrix. The ratio of distance to the vertex to focus and vertex to distance. But here, A by B, no? The distance of A is equal to B. Why? Because of vertex to focus distance will be equal to vertex to directrix distance. So A is equal to B. So that's why what it will come? 1. So for parabola, E is equal to 1. Okay, as next, for hyperbola, this is the V1 and this is the F1. For hyperbola, what will be there is, E is greater than 1. Why? Because of hyperbola is somehow opposite to the ellipse. For ellipse, it is E is less than 1, that of 1. So for hyperbola, E will be greater than that of 1. In technical way, what we can say is, this is A and this is B. The way E is equal to the ratio of A by B, where A is nothing but the distance between vertex to focus, B is nothing but the distance between vertex to directrix. So here, A is more than that of B. A is greater than that of B. So what will happen? It will become more than that of 1. The value will become more than that of 1. So for hyperbola, what I gave? E is greater than that of 1. The value of E is, sir, hyperbola we got, parabola we got, then what about rectangular hyperbola? For rectangular hyperbola, is equal to root 2. E is equal to root 2. And what is for straight line? For straight line, E is equal to 0. E is equal to 0 for straight line. Okay. So now E is equal to root 2 for rectangle hyperbola. E is equal to 0 for this straight line. All the statements which are coming out of my mouth are the exam questions. Nothing but the exam questions. Okay. Exam questions and answers also. Okay. So you can, the examiner can ask you in either ways. Okay. That's why I'm taking this much of time to explain you thoroughly. Okay, so this is about the nomenclature of ellipse, parabola and everything. Now I will start go in depth of knowledge in ellipse. Okay, kuchon start jayin okanda ha better da. So next I will tell you what is the basic, how a basic conic section will looks like. See, this is the directrix, this is the axis, and this is the conic section. Let us say this is the conic section, okay, and this is parabola. And this is hyperbola. Okay, see, now for all common things are there, V1 and F1, that means vertices and focus, vertex and focus, both are common for all three curvatures. Okay, so now this is the focus. So from focus, if you draw a line like this, then this is called it as latus rectum. This is called it as latus rectum. Okay, not only from this latus rectum is always perpendicular to the axis. This latus rectum always perpendicular with the axis. Okay, not only from focus, we can draw lines like this also. These lines are called it as, from here to here, it is called it as double ordinate. This is called it as double ordinate. Okay, this double ordinate, latus rectum and focus are common for all three curvatures, for ellipse, for parabola and for hyperbola. These are very common, these are the common things. Okay, and added to this, they will have chords like this. These are called it as chords. Okay, these are called it as chords. Okay, so chords also will be there. I will tell you in ellipse concept what is the chord and what is this everything. Okay, so this is about the thing, this is directrix and this is the axis. Okay, so now let's come to the point, ellipse. What is an ellipse? Where E is less than that of 1. E is less than that of 1, that means directrices will come close, little bit closer. This is V1, this is V2, and this is F1, and this is F2. This is the midpoint origin. Okay, this is called it as ellipse. Okay, for ellipse, you can draw chords, you can draw latus rectum and everything. Okay, so if you draw chords like this, you will get a very big chord which is coincides with V1, V2, which is coincides with the distance of V1, V2, and that is called it as largest chord. That is called it as largest chord, and that is known as major axis. That is known as major axis. Okay, and if you draw it like this, you will get minimum chord, smallest chord. That smallest chord is nothing but minor axis. That smallest chord is nothing but minor axis. Okay, so this is about ellipse. This is the largest chord, this is the major axis, and this is the minor axis. To draw circle, you don't need any so many methods. With the help of compass and with the help of pencil, you can easily draw circle. But to draw ellipse, there are different type of methods. The first one is concentric circles method. Okay, before going to this, ellipse has certain mathematical expression. That mathematical expression is nothing but x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Okay, and the distance between here to here is known as 2a, and the distance between here to here is known as 2b. Let us consider, okay, this is 2b, okay. The equation is x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1, okay. And this is having so many methods. To draw ellipse, you have different methods. To draw parabola, you are having different type of methods. To draw hyperbola also, you are having different type of methods. But there are some characteristic concepts regarding this ellipse, hyperbola and parabola, where the characteristic meets hyperbola and ellipse are both are similar, but parabola is a little bit different. Okay, so for this reason I am telling you, this is the 2a and this is the 2b. Let us say this is a b and this is c d. Okay, from o to a is call it as linear eccentricity, and this cd is call it as co-vertex or co-vertices, and this v1 to v2 is known as vertices. F1 to F2 is nothing but the distance between two fixed points. Okay, this is OA and this is co-vertices. CD is nothing but co-vertices. Okay, then the distance between O to A, the distance of O to A is always equal to C to F1 or C to F2. This is same, and this is equal to O to B also. The distance between distance between CF2 is equal to distance between OB. Okay, this is a IES question. You should make a note of it. Okay,